Moving on to the Analytic Engine. The Analytic Engine's main functionalities will be to support the end user in the appropriate actions to take in case of an attack, and it will do so by providing descriptive analytics of previous events. It shall also give historical data to the interactive dashboards for them to visualize with the attack types that have occurred to an organization over the previous days, with the time and date that each of those attacks was identified, and the most frequent actions followed by the users based on the attack type. It shall also give descriptive statistics to interactive dashboard for each of the organizations, like the mean number of each attack type occurrence over a specific period of time, which could be selected by the user, and provide an overview of the overall assessment of its organization's cybersecurity state. Here we see the sequence diagram of the analytics engine, and what we can say about this diagram is that the analytic engine is pulling the data which is stored in a MongoDB right now. It processes it and then provides to the interactive dashboard with the historical data, and is capable also of generating analytic charts. The interactive dashboards will then give back the selected suggestions, what we just saw on the previous demonstration of the decision support system. We'll store those suggestions on in the database, so that the analytic engine can then come back and have further analysis and provide the end user with the most frequent actions for a specific type of attack. Where we are currently is that the analytic engine is storing data from other components to its database. It is able to provide historical data of the attack types and the time that the attack was identified to the interactive dashboard. It is also able to give historical data to the interactive dashboard regarding those type of attacks, what type of attack is that occurred within an organization over, again, a period of time that is user-defined, and provide historical data regarding the attack that have previously occurred to this organization. Now we will see a short demonstration of how this component works. We can see here on the top left we have the traffic of the traffic type, which is also the same in this second diagram. On the third diagram to the top right, we have the attacks per hour that were identified. On the bottom left, we have again the attack types. It is, again, the user can select and deselect some things to have better visualization. Next to it, it's the same, but visualized in a different way. And on the bottom right, we have how many attacks were occurred by per source IP. So we know which source was responsible for most of the attacks. What we are now seeing is that we could also change the time interval of those statistics, and accordingly the diagrams are also changing. Okay, I think we got an idea. And for the next steps are to store the suggestions that the users have chosen from the decision support toolkit to the database and categorize those data according to attack type, so we can provide better analytics. Provide analytics with the most frequently used suggestions. This is what we want to do, depending on each attack type. And also be able to provide descriptive analytics for each organization with whatever information is relevant for them. Like, again, as we mentioned, the mean attack of a mean number of attack type occurrence over a period of time. All this will be depicted in deliverable 5.1, the SPHINX decision support engine on month 22. And this is all from both the DSS and the analytic engine. I would like to thank you for your time and attention.